Here in California, single-payer health care is on hold. The state Senate passed a bill earlier this month that said the state should give single-payer a chance, but it did not spell out how to pay for it. Assembly Speaker Anthony Rendon called that bill woefully inadequate, and so it's now stuck in committee.
Well, joining us to talk about this is State Assemblyman Phil Ting. All right, we have the Senate bill, we have the Washington bill. Chances are it's not going to enhance Obamacare.
Right.
It's going to mean result in some kind of cuts. Healthcare is very expensive here in California. There were estimates that it could cost the state up to $5 billion. Mm-hmm. We don't have that money.
Right.
What are we going to do?
Well, right now, we're worried about the $20 billion we might lose from Washington, which would be a full cut of all the Medi-Cal benefits and covered California benefits that we've been getting. Now, if we get cut, we have to figure out whether or not we're going to actually propose to the voters a raise in taxes. At this point, there's no appetite for that.
So how do we cover that? Morally and politically, for the last 50 years, this has been a centerpiece of Democratic politics, both nationally and in the state.
Right.
And people are still going to want their health care. And you're not going to be standing up in Sacramento bouncing people off health care. So how are we going to cover it?
Well, we've said, first of all, we want to preserve Obamacare. That's the first thing. They can not cut Obamacare. We have 5 million Californians who depend on Obamacare for health care right now. Now, there are additional Californians who aren't insured by Obamacare, and we've been looking at ways to go insure them. We've increased access for undocumented immigrants, especially kids.
But this is all based on that federal money still coming in. That federal money dries up in the next 12 months, what are you going to do? Raise another tax on tobacco? That's not going to cover it. You're talking serious money now.
That's right. I mean, at this point, that's why we've been directing people to talk to their Republican representatives, because they're the ones who actually have a vote on Obamacare, so that they understand. Kevin McCarthy in Bakersfield, half his adults are on Medi-Cal. Half.
All right, so you could beat him in election if they're taken off, but we're still stuck with having to pay for it one way or the other.
At this point, it's looking fairly unlikely that they move in that direction, but we're hoping that that's the case.
Well, there's going to be some movement. It may not be all as draconian as you're thinking about. Meanwhile, single payer, as it's called, which has become increasingly popular, was passed by the Senate. Mm-hmm. Everybody, stood up and said, yeah, and they handed it over to the State Assembly, and it promptly got parked in a cul-de-sac off to the side with the Speaker basically saying, this is poorly conceived and we don't have any money for it.
I'm a co-author of SB 562, support single payer, absolutely. The biggest problem with 562 is when it came over from the Senate, it didn't have a path to figure out how to pay for it.
That's because it was $400 billion.
That's right.
Nobody was going to figure that one out.
Is double the state budget, doubled the entire state budget. So that means all the money in the state budget, even if we put it there, only half of it would be able to cover that cost. So again, I think what the Speaker said, which is in his statement, is that we'd like the Senate to take a little more time, figure out how to pay for it before bringing it back to the legislature, the Assembly.
If we make healthcare a right in California, that covers everyone.
That's right.
And if there's no limits on what it is, I know we've talked about it for a long time, but if that's going to be the reality, again, how do we pay for it?
Well, you could pay for it in a way that we looked at it in San Francisco with Healthy San Francisco, where you actually had employers who weren't giving people health care actually had to pay into a pot, and that pot went into providing health care. But right now, that bill doesn't spell out any of those particular items. I think, obviously, we heard from President Trump that health care is complicated, and obviously, we need a little more time to figure out how to get to single payer. Most of us have supported the idea of single payer or having a public option for much of our lives, but we haven't figured out how to do it yet.
Yeah, and now we have this push to try to be a beacon of light for the rest of the country to follow. And there's concerns that if we turn on that light, that we're going to attract people to come here.
Well, and I think that we have to figure out, we have a lot of people, millions of people right now in California who don't have health care. So that's the first step.
Okay, and it would also include people here, no matter how they got here or what they're doing here, right?
That's what
legals
we had hoped, because right now, those folks show up at your county hospitals. They show up in your emergency room. We're already paying for it, Phil.
All right. Now, today is Pride. You're getting down on the parade. This is a very political statement this year.
Well, this year, it's really about pride and how we live and being able to live how we choose. Right now, you've heard some of the clips talk about people telling others how to live. We want to be able to express ourselves the way we do, and I think that's why there's so much support, not just from those in the LGBT community, but really all of us straight allies, too.
So from rainbow to resistance.
That's right.
That's how it evolves. I want to thank you for joining us, Assemblyman Phil Ting. Now